Hello, good morning students. See, welcome back to our e-learning session. And this is your fifth lecture of statistics chapter number 5. See, in our last session, we complete up to illustration number 5. And I was give you the homework of exercise 5.1, question number 6 and 7. Okay, so I hope you complete that, and if you have any doubts, then please ask me in our Zoom lecture or WhatsApp me, call me. Okay, now see, we will continue with our next illustration, that is illustration number 6. And in this illustration, just so that mixed distribution is given. Mixed distribution means what? First district group data 0, 3, 5, 8, and after that continuous group data 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. So here again we can say that mode is ill-defined. The third condition of mode ill-defined is in the data given is mixed distribution. Then you cannot find out this mode, and that's why here we have to again find out the median. And we have to use the Carl Pearson method. See the question, find the skewness and coefficient of skewness using it only. Here there is no any specification regarding using the Carl Pearson method, but here we don't see the Bowley's method, okay, and that's why here we just have to take a Carl Pearson's method. And in that second method, when mode is ill-defined, okay, so here we have to take median formula for the coefficient of skewness and skewness. Here I am starting that illustration number 6. Annual advertisement cost in lakh rupees. Next, number of companies, that is your F. Here, the question 3, 5. Then 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, and then 30 to 40. Frequency 3, 4, 5, 10, 5 to 1. N is equal to 30, now what we need, mid value first of all, mid values, that is your X. Here the mid value or X is equal to, in the discrete group data as it is, no change, 0, then 3, then 5, then 8. Now 10 to 20, that is 10 plus 20 divided by 2, that is 15. Then 20 to 30, 20 plus 30 divided by 2, that is 25. And then 30 to 40, so 35. Here the mid values is 0, 3, 5, 8, 15, 25 and 38. Okay, now DI shortcut method. Again, there is no any special common amount in the x. That's why we are not taking c. Only x minus a. Di is equal to x minus a. And here the amount of a is equal to 15. Common amount taken, or we can say assume as a is equal to 15. So 0 minus 15, so minus 15. 3 minus 15, so minus 12. 5 minus 15, so minus 10. 8 minus 15, so minus 7. 0, 10, and 20. FIDI. Then FIDI square. And then CF, cumulative frequency. FIDI, these into this, minus 45, then minus 48, then minus 50, then minus 70, then 0, 20, 20. Sigma FIDI is equal to minus 173, yes. Then FIDI square, these into this. FIDI square, FIDI into DI, that is FIDI square. And here it is minus minus plus 675. Sigma FIDI square is equal to yes. And now CF column. F, that is 3. Then 4, 7, then 5, 12, then 10, 22, 5, 27, 2, 29, and 30. Here, all the values, what we need, x bar, for x bar we need a plus sigma FIDI upon n. Here, we cannot take c because here mixed distribution is there. So no any equal class interval here, that's why we cannot take a C. So here the formula for X bar is equal to A plus sigma FIDI upon N only. So A is equal to 15 plus sigma fi di minus 173 upon n is equal to 30. So 15 plus minus minus 173 divided by 30. Do the calculation in your calc. 5.7667 9.23, and here in lakh rupees, that's why lakh rupees, your x bar is equal to 9.23 lakh rupees. Okay, x bar is over. Now median, first of all median class is equal to n by tooth observation. Is equal to n by 2, n is equal to 30. So 30 by 2 the observation. So 15th observation. And here we can see in the cumulative frequency column, 15 is lies here between 12 to 22. So here the corresponding amount, directly, not class, corresponding amount, that is here observation is 8. So here no any need about the class. Here m is equal to, or you can say median is equal to, directly 8 corresponding amount, which sees in CF, that is the observation is 8. So here your median is equal to 8 lakh rupees. So value of median is also find out very easily, because there is no any need to take a median class, as well as we don't have to take the median class continuous group data's formula, right? Median continuous group data's formula we don't have to take, because here the mixed distribution is there, and that's why here you can say ungrouped data corresponding the observation is directly in ungrouped data, and that's why 8 is our median, 8 lakh rupees. Okay, so now standard deviation, now we have to find out the next point, that is standard deviation. Shortcut formula, sigma fi di square upon n minus sigma fi di upon n all square. We don't have to multiply with c, because we are not taking any c common in di. And here also the observations, all the observations, class interval of the all the observation is also not equal, and that's why here we cannot take here a C as a common, or we cannot multiply C into the formula. Okay, now put the value here, is equal to into the square root sigma fi di square 2841 divided by 30 minus minus 173 divided by 30 all square. Make the calculation in your calc. 2841 divided by 30, that is 94.7, minus minus 173 divided by 30, that is, and its square directly is 33.2544. So now 61.4466 5, 6. 61.4456, and the square root of these is 7.8387. So you can say here S is equal to 7.8387, or you can say exactly S is equal to 7.84 lakh rupees. The value of S now here. So now you can say that here what the value of x bar as well as the value of median as well as the value of S is given here. Now we want what? We want skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness. Okay, so here I am finding out that skewness and coefficient of skewness. That is SK, and formula for that is equal to 3 into bracket x bar minus median. So put the value here, x bar is equal to what? 9.23, median is equal to 8 exactly. So here 3 into 1.23, so 3.69 lakh rupees. Is your SK skewness is equal to 3.89 lakh, and next point is coefficient of skewness that is J is equal to 3 into bracket x bar minus M upon S. Or you can say J is equal to SK upon S. The SK value of SK is 3.69, and the value of S is equal to 7.84. Therefore, the value of J is equal to, find out, 3.69 divided by 7.84. 0.4707, or you can say here J is equal to 0.47 exactly. J is equal to 0.47 is the final answer. And here we cannot write in lakh rupees because here the absolute measure is not free from unit, but the relative measure is always free from unit. That's why we don't have to write down 0.47 lakh rupees only. In the x bar, that is 9.7, 9.23, then 8, then 7.84, and last one is 3.69. In that case, we have to write down in lakh rupees. But in the coefficient of skewness, we cannot write down in lakh rupees because it's a free from measure. Okay, so here your illustration number 6 is over, very easy. So please write down first and then we will discuss about the next illustration. This is compulsory your 5 mark sums. Whenever the continuous group data is given and you have to find out the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness, or whenever the mixed distribution is given, here you can say this is a 5 mark sum. One mark for each and every calculation. Here x bar 1 mark, median 1 mark, standard deviation 1 mark, skewness 1 mark, and J, that is coefficient of skewness 1 mark. So here, very easy. And 5 mark sum. If you have a practice, if you know the formula, all the formulas and calculations very hard, very speedily, not by using calculator. Okay, so here, whenever you are in a speed in the calculation, then you can say here these 5 mark sum minimum get here these 5 mark sums you will get this in the only 10 minutes. You will do this sum only in 5 to 10 minutes very easily, right? So here you will get 5 to 10 minutes 5 marks full. Okay, so please do the practice in your rough book for these sums. So it's easy in the examination. Now illustration number 7. First of all, I am reading the question first, but well, okay, before that, please write down these. Okay, so now I am reading that the frequency distribution of hourly wages paid to 600 workers is given below. Find the Carl Pearson coefficient of skewness from this distribution. Here the continuous group data is given. See the continuous group data. First of all, see the highest frequency. Where the highest frequency? At the end. See, the highest frequency is not in the middle. Whenever mode is defined, when the highest frequency is in the middle, this is the new situation. See here, 10, 12, see the frequency first. 10, 12, 16, 20, increasing. 50, 60, 72, 100, 120 and 140. Here, the maximum frequency 140 is not in the middle, so you cannot say it as mode is defined. If the highest frequency of the distribution is in the middle, right, then you can say the mode is defined. Here again, new situation is there where mode is ill-defined. In the continuous group data, only three situations are there. First, if the class interval is not equal. Second, if the mixed distribution is given. And the third, if the highest frequency repeated twice. Okay, so these three situation mode is ill-defined. But here again a new situation is given, that is 140 highest frequency is given at the end. Here at the end, that's why here you can say if the highest frequency given in the middle, then you can say mode is defined. Okay, if it is not given or nearest to middle, not exactly in the middle but nearest to middle, then you can say mode is defined. Otherwise, mode is ill-defined. Okay, so here in this case again, see the class length is equal 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100 and so on. And as well as here, no any mixed distribution is given. And as well as one time only, the highest frequency is only in the one time. So you can say mode is defined. No, the new situation is there here that mode is ill-defined because the highest frequency is not given in the nearest to middle. It is given on the right hand side. Okay, so here it is again, you can say mode is ill-defined and you have to take compulsory median formula of Carl Pearson. See, I am reading the answer, that is 1-2 line given. In that case, the maximum frequency in this distribution is 140, which is for the last class instead of the central class, right, nearest to center or central class. Hence the mode is again ill-defined. So we will find out the coefficient of skewness. Here we have to find out the coefficient of skewness only, but for that we have to find out first of all skewness, right? if we find out, if we want coefficient of skewness, for that we have to find out the skewness also. So here only one question is asked. We have to find out the coefficient of skewness by Carl Pearson method. The Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness from this distribution we have to find out. Okay, so now I am doing the sum. Please concentrate here. Illustration number 7. Hourly wages in rupees. Then number of workers. That is your F. First of all, I am writing out the question. 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, 100 to 120, 120 to 140, 140 to 160, 160 to 180, 180 to 200, 200 to 220, and 220 to 240. Yes. Now the frequency. Here the frequency is 10, 12, 16, 20, 50, 60, 72, 100, 120 and 140. So your N is equal to total frequency. Make the total first. What is your total frequency? The total is 600. Okay, now what we need, first of all, mid values. That is your X. What is the mid value here? 50 first. Because 40 plus 60, that is 100, 100 divided by 2, that is 50. And here class length is equal. So it's very easy. We just have to add 20 to find out the next mid values. Because the class length of each and every class is 20. That's why just add 20 to find out the next mid values. 70, 90, 110, 130, 150, 170, 190, 210 and 230. Now DI is equal to XI minus A upon C. Here we have to take CY because the class length of each and every class is equal, and the middle one I am taking as A. So here A is equal to 150 and C is equal to 20. So just put here 0, then minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, then 1, 2, 3 and 4. See, minus is high and plus positive is low. That means here you have a chance to make a mistakes. Okay, so whenever if it is taken, see, I am taking 150 as only to explain you that here if you are assuming 150 as A, then here positive values are only 4 and the negative values are 5. So here chances to do a mistake is very high. Whenever minus or negative signs are very high, then the chances to make a mistake is high. That's why here I am not taking, here I am taking 130 as A and change the values. Here 150, I am not taking 150. It is just for your to explain you here I am taking 150, because if it is taken, then minus value is more than the positive values. Okay, so here we have to be careful about that. We have to take 130 as a A. Now what? Now see here, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So positive is high and negative is low. That is, you can say positive is more than the negative, and then the chances to do a mistake is very low. Now FIDI multiplication, then FIDI square, and then CF column, because here again, see, in this case also we have to find out median. That's why CF column we have to prepare. Now what? FIDI, these into these, minus 40, minus 36, minus 32, minus 20, 0, 60, 144, 300, 480, 700. Sigma FIDI is equal to, make the total, +480 +300 +144 +60 -20 -32 -36 and -40. So the answer is 1556. Sigma FIDI is equal to 1556. Now the square. Square means multiplication of these two, FIDI into DI, that is FIDI square. So 4 4s are 16, minus minus plus, so 160, 108, 64, minus minus plus, then 20 again, 0, 60, 288, 900, 1920, and the last is 3500. sigma fi di square is equal to, make the total 160 plus 108 plus 64 plus 20 plus 60 plus 288 plus 900 plus 1920 plus 3500. So 7020 is the value of sigma fi di square. In the last CF, cumulative frequency 10 plus 12, 22 plus 16, 38 plus 20, 58 plus 50, 108 plus 60, 168 plus 72, 240 plus 100, 340 plus 120, 460 and plus 140, 600. Okay, so here all the values of class, frequency, two items are given, mid values, DI, that is shortcut, FI DI, FI DI square and CF, all the values are here. Now just put the value into the formula and find out the answer. See the formula first. X bar is equal to A plus sigma fi di upon n into C. We can take C here because class length is equal in each class. Okay, so here A is equal to 130 plus sigma fi di 1556 divided by n 600 into C, that is 20. So 130 as it is plus 1556 into 20 divided by 600. So 51.8666. So you can say here 181.87 is the final answer. And this one is in rupees, that's why rupees. So here your X bar is complete. Now you have to find out the median. First of all, median class is equal to n by 2th observation. That is here n is equal to 600 by 2 observation, that is 300 observation, and it lies between here 240 to 340. So corresponding class is equal to 180 to 200. You can say median class is equal to 180 to 200, and therefore L is equal to, here exclusive type of data, and that's why here 180 is the value of L, then n by 2, again CF, n by 2, that is 300, then CF, CF is equal to the previous class cumulative frequency, that is 240. F is equal to corresponding class frequency, that is 100, and C, again the class interval is 20, so C is equal to 20. So now put the value here, therefore median is equal to L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into C, that is L's value is 180 plus n by 2, here 300, माइनस CF, CF इज इक्वल टू 240 अपॉन F, F इज इक्वल टू 100 एंड हियर मल्टीप्लाई बाय 20. सो 180 प्लस 300 माइनस 240 दैट इज 60 एंड 60 इंटू 20 डिवाइडेड बाय 100. दिस टू आर कॉल्ड कैंसल. सो 180 प्लस 12 एंड द फाइनल आंसर दैट इज मीडियन इज इक्वल टू 192 रुपीज. Median is equal to 192 rupees. Okay. So now two values, median and x bar. We find out that now the next value, that is standard deviation, we have to find out. S is equal to the formula for S into square root sigma fi di square upon n minus sigma fi di upon n all square into c. Fi di square 7020 upon n that is 600 minus 1556 divided by 600 all square into 20. So make first calculation 7020 divided by 600. So 11.7 minus 1556 divided by 600. 2.593 square into 20. 11.7 minus 6.72537 into 20. That is 4.9746 into 20 square root. S is equal to 2.2303, or you can say 04. Into 20 so x is equal to 44.6077 or you can say s is equal to approximately 44.61 rupees. So here the value of S is also find out. Now the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness, but here skewness is not asked, that's why you don't have to do the skewness. Okay, so you just have to find out the coefficient of skewness. Directly I am writing out coefficient of skewness, that is J is equal to 3 into bracket x bar minus m upon s. 3 into bracket x bar is equal to what? 181.87 minus m is equal to 192, exactly 192 divided by s is equal to 44.6. 61 181.87 minus 192 minus 10.13 divided by 44.61 into 3. So here minus 30.39. -0.6812 and you can say therefore J is equal to -0.68 is the final answer. See, we don't need skewness because they are not asking about the skewness, that's why I'm directly finding out the coefficient of skewness. And yes, you have to write down in the last line, that is, does the given frequency distribution has a negative skewness? We have to just say that does the given frequency distribution has a negative skewness. So here your sum is over, that is illustration number 8 is over, illustration number 7 is over. Please write down these first. So first of all, you have to find out in this x bar, then median, then standard deviation, and then directly coefficient of skewness. But here mode is ill-defined. The new one in this sum is mode is ill-defined because of new situation. See, only three situations are there: when mixed distribution, when not equal interval of class, and when the highest frequency is repeated two times, then here we can say that mode is ill-defined. But this is the new situation. In this case, in this sum, three, all the situations are fulfilled. But a new situation is there. The highest frequency is at the end of the class, that is in the last class, and it is not in the central. That's why here you can say mode is also ill-defined. This is a new situation when the highest frequency is not given into the center, but it is given in the starting point or in the first class or in the last classes. Then here you can say the mode is again ill-defined, and you have to take this median formula to find out the coefficient of skewness by Carl Pearson method. Okay, so here your seventh illustration is over, and I hope you complete this. Now the eighth illustration is the short sum. Here up to seven illustration, this is the 5-mark sums. Okay, but now after that, here the directly all the values we are finding out here, all the values of x bar, that is mean, median, mode or standard deviation, and then put the value in the coefficient of skewness, right? Or skewness or coefficient of skewness. But after that, now short sums is here. In that, directly all the values, that is n, mean, median, standard deviation, all the values of two datas here it is given, and we just have to compare, we just have to find out the skewness of one data as well as the skewness of the second data, or you can say coefficient of skewness of first data and the coefficient of skewness of the second data, compare that and give the decision whatever they ask into the question, high, low, whatever they ask. We have to write down coefficient of skewness of two different data is, we have to find out by given information, that is by x bar, median, standard deviation, and all the values are given here. We don't have to find out like this. That's why this is a short sum. Okay, and we just have to find out two different data's coefficient of skewness and compare it and give the decision or give the answer whatever the question is there. See illustration number 8, 9, 10, all are just like that. Equal, that is two data is given, different two data is given, and we have to find out the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness. It is negative, it is positive, we have to make the decision, we have to give a conclusion for these two data. Okay, in illustration number 8, 9 and 10, and in the illustration number 11, just a short sum, that is for 2 marks is given. Here we have to also see that we will see in our next lecture. All the short sums will do in our next lecture. So please do this right now. First of all, you have to complete in your example book 7 illustration, up to 7 illustration, as well as in the exercise book 5.1 full you have to complete. That is, now see, only one question, first, second, third, fourth, over. 6-7 is also, I hope you complete that. And now the next, only the remaining one question, that is mixed distribution question, question number 5 is given, and it is just like illustration number 6. Okay, so here you have to do this sum and you have to complete exercise 5.1. Now next homework, see, next topic is Bowley's coefficient method, Bowley's skewness and coefficient of skewness method. And after that, see exercise 5. You have to write down in your exercise book after exercise 5.1, only one sum is remaining. After writing out one sum, that is complete the exercise 5.1, after that you have to write down exercise 5, section A and section B. See, you have to do section A and section B, and you have to find out all the theories from the textbook, as well as all the short sums, that is one mark sum, given in section B as well as in section A. And you have to do these sums in your exercise book, all the theories as well as short sums of one mark you have to do in your exercise book. So your homework is exercise 5.1 full and exercise 5, section A and section B. Okay, see the exercise. In A, up to 8 illustration, the theories are there. Then 9, again one property is given. In 10, you have to find out the values of J. Theory, 12 theory, 13 theory and 14 theory. Okay, so here in only one question is there as a practical, in section A and section B up to 14 all the questions are a theory. See, some questions are regarding Bowley's methods, then leave 2-3 lines. Here in section B, some questions are regarding Bowley's method, then at that time here you have to leave 2-3 lines for that, and please complete the remaining all the questions regarding Carl Pearson's method, all the theory of Carl Pearson method, as well as the short sum given in section B. So please do the homework. Whatever, if you have any doubts regarding these section A and section B, then please ask me in our Zoom lecture. Okay, we'll discuss and I am solving that particular doubts of section A and B as well as exercise 5.1 in that Zoom lecture. Okay, so here I'm complete my lecture. So thank you class, have a nice day, bye bye.